Please stand by for a priority communication from Supreme Chancellor Leontine Suresh of the Galactic Republic.
It's a great honor to speak with the warrior who struck down the Emperor. The Republic needs your strong arm once again.
It's about time you contacted me. With the Emperor out of the way, the Sith are primed for a fall.
I regret. Our greatest foe must wait while we deal with a new enemy. The Hutt Cartel has invaded Republic space and seized the planet Makeb. We will respond to this unprovoked act of aggression in full force. My war council will be convening on Keylander Station in the Makeb system. I ask that you join us immediately.
I'll set a course for the Makeb system right now.
Conference chamber on Keylander Station. I'll meet you there. Please hurry. We must act quickly and decisively against the Hutt's aggression.
Most cordial greetings. I am Zan Threlo, Republic Protocol Officer. Welcome to Makeb and Keylander Station. Please hold all questions. Supreme Chancellor Suresh and her delegation are arriving.
Assembled friends, the Republic owes its continued survival to this brave Jedi. Entire worlds would be smoldering ruins if not for this hero's courage and sacrifice.
I doubt all these people came just to hear you flatter me, Chancellor. The situation on Makeb must be bad.
The crisis we face is unexpected and severe. I require my best advisors and most able problem solvers. Victory over the Empire lies within our grasp. But first, we must face a cowardly act of unwarranted aggression. Supreme Commander Malcolm.
13 days ago, the Hutt Cartel violated Republic space and seized the planet Makeb. They've blockaded the system with 30 Ajur-class heavy cruisers.
Makeb's citizens have formally pledged to join the Republic if we respond to their crisis. We will not abandon them to the Hutt's brutality.
The planet must have something of value if the Hutts are risking outright war for it.
I don't care what motivates them. I want their blight removed from our space.
Severe atmospheric conditions on Makeb make large-scale troop landings impossible. We need help from local resistance forces to pull this off.
One of Makeb's business leaders, Shayla Mavesta, is awaiting you on the surface. I want you working closely with him.
We couldn't have freed Balmora or Corellia without help from the locals.
Shalem is a patriot who led his people to embrace the Republic. We mustn't desert him. Liberating Makeb is your top priority. But I want the Hutt's ambitions ended permanently. Grandmaster Satil Shan has insight regarding our enemy's future plans.
The Jedi Council has meditated on the cartel's actions. We believe that Makeb is a staging point for a larger attack on the entire galaxy.
The Hutts will not be allowed to expand their dominion at our expense.
It's always an honor to face down the enemies of the Republic, Madam Chancellor.
When our enemy realizes who they're facing, I predict a hasty retreat. A shuttle will transport you to Shayla Mavesta's encampment on the surface. Go now, and show the galaxy the Republic is not to be trifled with.
You're one of the Republic heroes come to free my homeworld. You're just... wow. I wish we'd joined the Republic ages ago.
Your people could have joined us when the Sith Empire returned to the galaxy. What stopped you?
That was before my time, but we've always minded our own business and not gotten involved in other people's fights. Stupid, huh? I was here when the Hutts blocked all of Makeb's comm channels. Haven't been able to get a signal from my family since. No idea what's happened down there.
There's only one way to find out. Fire up that shuttle's engines.
Don't know if they told you, but Makeb's atmosphere's a real mess. Most ships get torn to bits by electrical storms on entry. My baby's got special ion shields to absorb the electromagnetic interference, but we're still in for a rough ride. Hopefully we won't land in little pieces.
How did the cartel conquer your planet if most ships can't even get through the atmosphere?
Our politicians figured, why draft an army when you can hire mercenaries? We bought the best. Bunch of hard cases called the Interstellar Regulators. But the Huts didn't bother fighting them. They bought off the Regulators with a bigger bid. Ask Shalem of Vesta. He'll tell you. My shuttle's prepped. Hop aboard and we'll be on our way. I want to take your anti-nausea stims, too.
You honor my home, Master Jedi. I'm Shalem of Vesta. The Supreme Chancellor promised us relief, but you're more than I ever hoped. My family helped found Mekeb. The Vesta Mining has led our business council for decades. I was practically chief of state before the cartel's takeover. It wasn't an easy decision. But if joining the Republic is the only way to reclaim my home world's freedom, so be it.
You don't sound happy about this alliance. What made your decision to accept the Republic's help so difficult?
Mekeb's been independent since our founding. It's always been part of our people's character. Ilosoth is a former mercenary with the Interstellar Regulators. Until recently, Mekeb's trusted private army and police force.
Quit when the Regulators sold out to the Huts. I don't betray a client for credits.
Exceptions like him notwithstanding, the cartel bought off the Regulator forces and turned our former protectors against us.
How many ex-mercenaries do you have on your side? Enough to take down the rest?
Regulators who refused the Hut buyout either ran or got shot for disloyalty before they could.
I still don't know why this has happened. We've conducted peaceful business with the Hut cartel for years.
Casualty and damage reports coming in. Talao City got rattled pretty hard, but no injuries. Lucky.
That's the fifth groundquake since the Hut's takeover. The last one leveled the Tygon mining colony. They're still pulling bodies from the rubble.
Deadly atmosphere, groundquakes, and covered in huts. Real paradise you've got here.
I'll have you know we've built some of the finest vacation resorts outside the core systems.
Won't matter if these groundquakes demolish them all.
My niece Lemda is a respected geophysicist. She joined our resistance to prove there's a link between the groundquakes and the Hut's deep core mining.
She was taking seismic readings on a deserted mesa when a whole company of Regulators swarmed in. We lost contact with her.
I sent search parties to bring Lemda back, but they aren't trained or equipped to fight a mercenary force of that size.
I have a feeling your niece discovered something, and the Hut sent the Regulators to stop her from getting away.
That's my fear as well.
Getting reports from our search parties. Dozens of Regulators have pushed them back to the landing zone. We lose that, we'll never find Lemda.
If your allies can hold out until we arrive, we'll break the siege and rescue your niece. You have my word as a Jedi.
Once they know you're on the way, my people will fight twice as hard. Take my personal shuttle to Fryn Mesa. Lane Farrow is our man at the landing zone.
Shalem of Vesta sent us. You're in charge here?
Reinforcements! We're saved! Frosk, come here! It's a Jedi!
Speak up, Lane. Not sure the whole Mesa heard you. My name's Prosk, in case Slick here didn't enunciate clearly. Kid's an accountant. Barely knows which way to point a blaster. Can't say I'm much better. Used to be a mining foreman. We've set up barricades, but they're not doing much against the Regulators. What's the plan, boss?
What are we up against here? Have you seen the Regulator forces?
There's a lot of them. They're mean and well-armed. We didn't introduce ourselves. Scouts report Regulators headed this way. Big group.
Everyone's manning a barricade. Find one and dig in! Master Jedi, I've never... Those regulators... You're incredible!
I'll drink to that, Slick. Those mercs will think twice about hitting us again. We owe you one.
You boys have any leads on Lemda, our missing geophysicist? She's the reason we're all here.
Her campsite was ransacked. The regulators must have already captured her and confiscated all the research data. Shalem's right. She found something important.
She might have escaped on foot before the mercenaries hit her camp.
Maybe. But then why hasn't she contacted us for help?
Scanners indicate no one except you has landed on or left the Mesa since the regulators came. That means she's still here. Probably at one of their camps.
Great. There's half a dozen camps and no way to pinpoint which one she's at. Have to keep hitting them until she turns up.
How big and well-defended are the mercenary camps? I'm guessing our enemies aren't sitting around roasting brobolos and singing.
All we know is the regulators dropped a whole mess of men here with who knows what firepower. A few of our search parties never made it back. You find any other prisoners, send them here.
Someone here might know how to slice the regulators' comm frequency and find out what they're doing. Ask around, Prosk.
Slick takes charge with his big brain. On it, boss.
We'll hold this landing zone as long as it takes. Good luck.
Red Team, come in. This is Vice Commandant Brevin. We've scanned heavy fire in your zone. Status report.
Start running now. You might get out alive.
You're outnumbered by troops who have run ops in 30 systems. Our victory rate is 100%. You got lucky this time. It won't happen again. You should have taken the hint. I command the regulators, and I've got plenty of reinforcements to throw your way. Now they're angry.
The longer you waste my time, the worse it'll be when I find you.
Good luck with that. My regulators get double pay to bring me your head.
It's Prosk, you read? We sliced the Merc's comm network. Hearing all kinds of interesting chatter. Whatever you're doing, it's paying off. The Merc's have pulled back. The landing zone's all ours.
Take the battle to them. Chase that scum off the nearest cliff.
Understood. We'll keep listening to the Merc's bellyache, too. Might learn something we can use. Keep up the pressure.
Prosk, come in. We've taken out multiple regulator camps. Still no sign of Lemda.
Scouts report you've got those mercenaries chasing their own tails. Lemda has to be nearby. I'll take some men out and cover more ground.
Think you're clever? Killing my people? Slicing our comm channel? Every time you hit us, the Hutts crack down even harder on the nice people of Mekeb. They're dying because of you.
You're supposed to protect Mekeb, but you sold out to the Hutts. How much are they paying you to execute innocent people?
Enough, obviously. Make your peace while you can.
Prosk, do you read? Another camp down and still no Lemda. Any luck on your end?
Hang on. Getting a distress call. It's her! Patching through!
Blast, is this stupid thing working? Hello? Hello?
We read you, Lemda. Your uncle sent a rescue team. The Republic's here. Look!
Shalem didn't send more?
He told us you're a respected geophysicist. You look like a student. How old are you?
I received my doctorate 8 years ago. I was 16. Intimidated yet? My guards abandoned their posts and left me alone. You must be the murdering scum they went after. I broke free and ran to the nearest quake shelter. I'm the only person here. Sending you coordinates.
That's always nice when prisoners help with their own rescues.
Didn't have anything to lose by trying. Wait, what was that noise? Is that on your end?
Lost her. They're blocking her signal. My team's close to that quake shelter. Meet you there.
No!
You got a lot of my friends killed today. Grevin said I could return the favor.
You're all dead.
You scum!
The shelter's collapsing! We have to get out!
Let's end this! My force! The lowest bidder?
Go! Or we're dead!
There's never been a ground quake like that in McKeb's history. Geologic instability has increased 1,000-fold since the Hutt takeover. Seismic readings and core stability fluctuations both indicate impending catastrophe. These ground quakes are the direct result of Hutt deep core mining that's going to destroy McKeb.
Did you fall and hit your head? Not even the Hutts have the power to break a planet.
I didn't know I was speaking to a fellow geophysicist. Oh wait, I'm not. Every scrap of data I collected here proves the Hutt cartel's deep drilling has destabilized McKeb. These ground quakes are only the start. Entire mesas will collapse. After that, gravitational decay will strip away the atmosphere, kill everything. McKeb will become totally uninhabitable.
If we shut down the cartel's mining operations, would that save McKeb?
It'll only slow the inevitable. We need a better solution. I think there's a way to save McKeb, but I need you to work with me. I'll warn you now. I'm snappish. Everyone says so. It's not personal.
I'd say you're handling yourself just fine under the circumstances.
My family is full of politicians. They say this is my way of rebelling. Did I mention I'm the one who convinced Uncle Shalem to contact the Republic? You're welcome.
You made it! We followed Prosk's signal and... Where's Prosk?
I'm sorry. He didn't... He's gone.
Get her on a shuttle back to Shalem. The regulators are scattered. They shouldn't give you any trouble.
If they try, I'll shoot them all.
Meet me at Uncle Shalem's office. We need to figure out a plan. Fast. This is nothing, Uncle. I've run the numbers. 2 days, maybe less. And your office is at the bottom of a sinkhole.
At least your expensive education has finally amounted to something.
Told you I'd repay that loan. Bet you're wishing you'd listened to me sooner. Not dismissed me as a loudmouth conservationist.
Master Jedi, Lemda told me of your incredible rescue. Words cannot convey my thanks. We suspected McKeb was becoming unstable, but I had no idea things were this bad. We never should have let the Hutt cartel establish their mining operation.
I didn't realize the cartel set up shop on your world before the takeover.
We negotiated mining contracts with them a decade ago. They gave our economy a tremendous boost.
I've been yelling about that boost for years. Moving on. The regulators who held me hostage were a chatty bunch. Mostly filthy language and bragging about their blasters, but the leader said something interesting. He mentioned Project Failsafe, a Hutt emergency plan if their mining went wrong. That mercenary believed the Hutts have something to instantly stabilize McKeb.
Did the mercenary say anything else about Project Failsafe? Where it is? How it works?
The conversation dried up when you started attacking their camps. Not that I'm ungrateful.
Millions could die while we wait for the Hutts to act. We need to claim Project Failsafe for ourselves before it's too late.
Talos City, the Hutt Embassy database.
Ilasov's right. Data on Project Failsafe would be stored in the Hutt Embassy's computers in Talos City. Unfortunately, that's under cartel control. We need Chief Herkwill, Talos City's former security commander. He and a few loyal men have a hidden camp outside the city. They'll get you inside the city and embassy.
How does the security chief know the way into the Hutt embassy?
Herkwill set up the Hutt's original defenses. He built it. He knows how to break it. The Hutts control Talos City and the surrounding area. They'll have to land a shuttle in the countryside. Expect plenty of regulators. Chief Herkwill's camp is hidden at these coordinates.
Don't die. You're all we've got.
Chief Herquil? Shalem Avesta sent us. He says you know a way into the Hutt embassy.
If I'd known a Jedi war hero was coming, I'd have cleaned myself up and made some lunch. Hutt embassy's locked up tight. Used to have a fancy-pants bureaucrat helping us inside, Representative Eklund, but he's gone quiet. Probably dead. Good news is, the cartel hasn't changed anything at their embassy. Got the same turrets, droids, passcodes I set up for them. Lazy Hutts.
When this is all over, we'll have to thank the Hutts for making our job simple.
They may be stupid, but they're still pretty good at killing folks. You want inside the Hutt embassy, you'll have to finesse three layers of security. First layer is heavy turrets in the courtyard. The only good thing to come out of these ground quakes is that they expose the turret power generators. Overload those, and turrets lose their punch.
I doubt the Hutts left those generators unguarded. How hard will it be to reach them?
City's under curfew. Streets are crawling with Hutt-loyal regulators. Security layer 2 is the embassy's main door. 3 meters of reinforced Durasteel. Even a lightsaber would take hours to cut through. But the door will unlock for a diplomatic passcode. You can generate one by accessing the government building secure terminal.
There have to be regulators on the street carrying passcodes. We'll be fighting them anyway, right?
Only top officers get into the embassy. You won't find them patrolling the streets. Last but not least are the security droids. Top of the line Arcanian models. Nasty disposition. Shoot intruders on sight. Good news is they can be reprogrammed. The droid control station in my old security HQ will do the trick.
After jumping through those first two hoops, I'll prefer to crush a droid army the old-fashioned way.
Not saying you couldn't, but probably not before everyone in the embassy got hustled to evac shuttles and the data banks with them. Hit those objectives and I guarantee you'll get inside the embassy. Whether you'll find your answers is a different matter. If Representative Eklund's still alive, maybe help him escape? He's a fuss budget, but basically all right. I'll keep a comm channel open when I can.
Acknowledging new ident code. Greetings, Senior Command Unit 223.
Good to know Chief Herquil's codes are still valid.
Feel free to inspect the embassy. You will find everything in order.
Wait, please. I'm an unarmed civilian. Representative Eklund with the Mekeb Provisional Authority Council. I'm the official liaison to the Hutt Cartel. Whatever you need, I'll make sure you get it. Just don't hurt me.
I'm working with Shalem Avesta. He sent me to get information on the Hutt Cartel's plans.
And he thought the best way to do it was to attack their embassy? Typical. Like it or not, the Hutts control Mekeb now. Our only option is to cooperate, make the best of our new situation. Instead, Shalem stirs up trouble. He doesn't realize how much worse the Hutts could make things for us.
Your emotions are blinding you to the truth. The Hutts are drilling into Mekeb's core. They've destabilized the entire planet.
Now you're the emotional one. A few ground quakes and suddenly it's the end of the world? It doesn't even make sense. The Hutts are here on the planet too. If Mekeb is destroyed, they die with it.
Geological readings show this planet is coming apart. But we think the Hutts have a Project Failsafe to deal with the situation.
Knowing Shalem, you'll risk anything to find it. Well, I'll save some lives and help quash this rumor for good. If this Project Failsafe exists, there must be some record of it in the Embassy's archives. I'll get you access to them. But the Hutts are on high alert. They've already summoned reinforcements. You'll have to deal with them. I'll meet you in the archive room.
Just do your part and leave the guards to me. I don't want you getting hurt.
The guards won't target me. That's why I prefer to travel separately. You worry about those reinforcements. I'll make sure we can access the Hutt archives. Good luck!
Security protocols have been disabled. Eklund came through.
Almost. I ran when I heard the fighting. Let me finish this. The Hutt in charge of Mekeb is named Taboro. If Project Failsafe exists, there should be some reference to it in his communication logs.
The Hutts are bound to be sending more reinforcements. We haven't got much time.
Here, a holo from someone named Vidrig has a Project Failsafe tag. Let's see what it says.
Greetings, O great and glorious Taboro. I'm happy to report that Project Failsafe is both on schedule and under budget. Your Grand Arc is approaching completion.
I have a bad feeling about this.
As these schematics illustrate, the Ark's ingenious outer layer will completely shield the vessel and its precious contents from Makeb's atmospheric unpleasantness. The cargo hold will store your entire Isotope 5 stockpile, while your chosen few companions travel in luxurious comfort on the Ark's upper decks.
I don't care about Taboro's private luxury barge. I need to know how the Hutts plan to keep Makeb from ripping apart.
Look at the size of that vessel. It is the Hutt failsafe. They'll fly away in their Ark and leave Makeb's people to die.
Mighty Taboro, may I suggest replacing these standard passenger cabins with deluxe suites more suited to a Hutt of your stature? I can easily add them before the Ark's completion.
Someone needs to make that Hutt suffer. I nominate me.
Taboro's filth. No one's arguing that. Especially not me right now. But killing him doesn't solve the real problem. Makeb will be destroyed, and millions will die. But if we steal the Ark, we could use it to evacuate the entire planet.
I thought there were millions of people in Makeb. Will they all fit inside that ship?
You saw the schematics. If we convert the cargo hold for passengers, the Ark should have enough room for everyone. There are only so many places the Hutts could hide such a massive project. We have to find it.
Maybe it's time to interrogate Vidrick's employer. Where do we find that slimy Hutt?
Taboro would never trust a native like me with his location. Besides, we need to get our hands on the Ark first. I'll scour these archives and transmit everything I find to Shalem. Given the circumstances, I feel rather unsafe remaining here. There's a shuttle pad nearby. If you remove the guards and unlock the shuttles, we could all fly away safely.
You're alive! Guess my advice worked, huh? Shalem told me to patch you through right away.
We're already analyzing the project failsafe plans Representative Eklund transmitted to us. They're sickening. Taboro the Hutt is masterminding the greatest crime in galactic history. With Vidrick's Ark, they'll escape Makeb and leave us all to die. We can't let that happen.
The only way that Ark's leaving is with us at the helm and Makeb's people safe inside it.
If there's any justice in the galaxy, we'll get to see the look on Taboro's face as we depart in his starship.
I matched the Ark's construction site map to topographic readings. The Ark's being built at a secret facility inside the giant sphere. That's a big tourist trap, a mesa with a hollow interior. Too dangerous to colonize, but perfect for hiding an Ark's construction.
With all these ground quakes, we'll be lucky if that place doesn't collapse and take the Ark with it.
All the more reason to move quickly.
Contact me when you're the giant spear. I'll help you plan this attack. It won't be an easy fight.
Don't look at me. I've got a city to evacuate. Good luck.
Ilasov, we're at the giant spear. What have you got for us?
We sent probe droids to scan the zone ahead of you. Their readings, not good news. Regulator fire teams are patrolling the site. Some of Vice Commandant Grevin's finest, backed by top lieutenants from the Hutt Cartel. Everyone's packing military hardware.
Any chance Grevin is commanding these forces? It'd be nice to have another talk with him.
Doesn't look like it. Too bad. That son of a Hutt deserves to fry with the rest of his two-faced traitors. The Ark construction site's behind a triple-plated durasteel blast door. Takes three separate keycards to open the thing. Only cartel representatives carry them. Guess the Hutts only trust the regulators up to a point. They need to find the cartel's top lieutenants and get their keycards.
Would it be possible to simply cut through the door with, say, a lightsaber?
You'd be at it for days. One thing Hutts know how to make is strong doors. Contact me when you've unlocked the blast door. I'll let you know if we find anything else in these files. Good luck.
Ilasov, we're through the blast door.
Good. Seal it behind you. There ought to be a control panel nearby. Scramble the security codes. That'll keep reinforcements from following you. Schematics for the Ark construction site are a mess. Can't tell what half the symbols mean. Just do whatever it takes to secure the Ark, and good luck.
This is insane. My men are working triple overtime, and we're still falling behind.
Work faster.
That's not... Look, we both know Vedrig's skimming off the top. If this keeps up, we'll never finish the arc.
You got a big mouth, Tiero. Maybe I'll shut it for you.
Why are you threatening this man?
Wait. You. You're who Taboro's yelling about. Give me a hand here. She's worth a fortune dead.
Republic, huh? Don't know what you're doing on Mekeb, but thanks. These cartel idiots won't listen to reason. I try calling for help and get a blaster shoved in my face. The Huts work us to death, treat us like slaves. No, like animals.
You stood up to that cartel thug pretty well. What's your name?
Tiero. I'm foreman here, for what it's worth. You saw what happens when I try to do my blasted job. It's all on Vedrig's orders. My men break their backs building his ark while he steals everything not bolted down. Thanks to Vedrig, the Ark's weeks behind schedule. My crew can't finish the ship while that slimy Deveronian's selling off its components.
That stupid Deveronian may have doomed the whole planet. I'll make sure he dies first.
Don't let him talk his way out of this. He's good at the chatter. I'll tell my crew to lay low. Put Vedrig in his place, and we'll help you out however we can.
Got the best Ugnaught engineer in 4 sectors on retainer. She's a genius with electroplumbing.
You'll have the classiest refresher in Coruscant, boss.
Still can't decide what to put in the sonic shower. Felucian glimmerstones look so elegant, but I love Rylothian onyx tile.
Why settle for just one? They're both excellent gravestones, and your days are numbered.
You're that Republic hero Taboro's screaming about on the Hollow. The cartel's so worried, they're paying double to finish the arc ahead of schedule. That's on top of what they're offering to kill you. Never let it be said I'm not generous in defeat. You can have this incredible marvel of starship design at a 20% discount. 30%?
I don't think you understand the gravity of your situation.
Gravity, huh? Good one. I admit the ship needs a little work, but she's almost ready to fly. Besides, being incomplete means there's room to customize. Let me live, and I'll have this baby ready to leave the atmosphere in no time. You won't find a better offer, trust me.
That speech might have worked on a Hut, but not me. Scum like you make me sick. Ugh!
This one's actually useful. We can put him to work.
Anything you want. I'll get my welding gloves.
Haven't had contact with the outside in weeks. This is Foreman Tiero, and Republic forces calling from Giant Spear. Does anyone read?
Loud and clear, Tiero. We sent those Republic forces. What's the Ark status? Is it secure?
Go ahead. Give him the bad news about the Ark.
It's incomplete, but... is the Ark that important?
Foreman, this is Shalem Avesta. Mekeb's core is tearing apart, and we can't stop it. That Ark is our people's only hope of escape. If I send you every able body I have and guarantee your safety, can you finish the Ark in time to evacuate our world?
I'll blasted well try.
The Huts are surely organizing a counterattack. We're forming a battle plan to defeat it. We'll brief you back here. Hurry.
We sealed the blast door to keep Hut reinforcements out, but there's bound to be another way out of here.
Vedrig kept a private shuttle pad nearby. You can take his transport while we get to work.
We can't thank you enough for securing the Ark, Master Jedi. You turned certain death into a chance for survival.
The Ark's missing more than a few vital components. We're still a long way off from loading it with evacuees.
Formentiero is one of the best shipmen on McKeb. He'll get the job done, if we protect his construction site. We intercepted priority signals from the cartel. Every regulator in this hemisphere has been ordered to retake the Ark, at all costs.
If we knew the Regulator Army's staging point, we could potentially cut them off.
Surest way to close any deal is by blocking the competition from bidding.
Some refugees know how to use a blaster. I'll organize the security force to protect the Ark. Navigator, we'll need your shuttle. Come on.
My people are scouting for Regulator activity and reporting what they find. We've identified one major staging area.
The Fingers. Originally one mesa, until a quake redecorated the place. Now, it's held together by a series of interconnected energy fields, light bridges.
The Regulators store heavy artillery and weapon caches there. If those mercenaries rearm, they'll blast us to oblivion.
We'll take their toys away, but I won't be happy until the Regulators have cashed their last credit vouchers. Point me at that scum.
We know the Regulators' army also includes war droids and a battle platform. We're still scouting for those.
Translation. He's finding lots of ways to risk your life.
You're trying to save your people, and we're your best chance. There's nothing to apologize for.
Who was apologizing?
Once you've destroyed the artillery and weapon caches in the Fingers, contact me. I should have additional targets by then. Good luck.
Shalem, come in. The Regulator's weapon caches are all destroyed.
Outstanding. I hope you're ready for more. We've detected an army of war droids massing for an attack. If those war droids make it across that bridge, they'll slaughter everyone in their path, including us.
You said the war droids are already in place. Why haven't they moved in?
We think they're awaiting orders from the Regulator Command Center. We're still hunting for that. The war droids are holding position for now, but you could lure them out by transmitting false orders from the mercenary army's comm towers. Once the droids are halfway across the light bridge, you could deactivate it. Drop the whole army into the depths.
Droids make hilarious noises when they're destroyed. Too bad we won't be able to hear them.
Slice into the mercenary comm towers, transmit the false marching orders, and deactivate the light bridge at the perfect moment. Good luck.
The war droid army is gone for good. The Regulators will think twice before setting foot on that light bridge.
I know the cost per unit of those war droids. Between them and the weapons you destroyed, the Regulators are over 300 million credits in the red.
If all they care about is money, there has to be a credit figure where retreat becomes the better option.
Our foes appear determined to throw good money after bad. We finally tracked down the main mercenary base. A floating battle platform called the Storm Carrier. Vice Commandant Greven, the mercenary leader, is gathering troops there. We can't let Greven's forces reach the Ark. The only way to stop the Storm Carrier is by overloading its power reactors to meltdown.
Should we eliminate Vice Commandant Greven, or is he worth more as a prisoner?
Greven knows the Hutts won't tolerate failure. I doubt he'll let himself be captured. Sending you the Storm Carrier's coordinates. Our scouts report there's a Regulator shuttle near your position. You can fly it directly to the enemy and take them completely by surprise. Everything's riding on this. May fortune smile on us all.
Warning. Warning. Reactors 2, 5, and 8. Approaching critical mass. Carrier cooling system has been disabled.
I knew you were ruthless, but you'd destroy this carrier. Kill everyone aboard just to make a point. If I didn't have to shoot you, I'd give you a job.
You're the ones who sent those regulators to kill Lemda, aren't you? I remember you from our holo chats.
I've been looking forward to this. Once you're dead, the cartel's paying us more than we'd earn in a lifetime from this planet's idiot government. McKeb can burn for all we care. So can your Republic. Isotope 5 will change everything. Once they're done mining McKeb, the Hutts will own this galaxy.
The Republic's seen such grand ambitions before. They never seem to last.
You've cost me a fortune today, but I can still recover my expenses. Time to settle your debt.
Meltdown in progress. Abandon ship. Repeat. Abandon ship.
You might need a lift. Hang on, I'm coming in.
People of McKeb, your heroes return.
Watch out. Uncle Shalem's running for president of whatever planet we all move to.
This heroic Jedi led us to victory against the Hutt treachery. Now we have freedom and an Ark that will deliver us to safety.
I know you're all scared. You have good reason. But the time for fear is ending. The Hutts only control you when you are broken and despairing. Look to your neighbors, your friends, your loved ones, for strength. Through compassion and hope, you will survive this. May the Force be with you.
I meant what I said. All of it. The Ark is safe, and we'll soon have it ready to fly. We've earned a moment to celebrate. Especially you.
Back at the Hutt Embassy, we found a holo that said the Ark was being built to transport something called Isotope 5. When we faced Greven, he said Isotope 5 will change the galaxy. But he wouldn't say how. Does that name mean anything to you?
Sounds more like some idiotic Hutt codename than a scientific discovery.
We finally have Mighty to borrow the Hutt's attention. Calling to congratulate us, old friend?
You're not much of a salesman, Taboro. But I've always wanted to see a Hutt grovel. Can you actually bend over enough to kiss the ground?
Spare us your empty threats, Taboro. McKeb is doomed, and the Ark is our only escape. If we give it back, we're all dead.
Gibdaya kun boska bolia. Kosa, konyo, lasta wantiki ato konchi.
Do you honestly expect us to believe that? You've been lying since you arrived on Makeb.
No kabaye ulwani kuseya bolio. La choba non botafa, avati kun achi don ignaloria. Ogni gioca, non c'è, ci cava una digitua.
I recognize where that droid was attacking. Tarlum, it's a small city without defenses. I'll summon a shuttle to take you there. Please, save my people.
I don't care how big Tabaro's weapon is. I've never met a machine that could defeat a Jedi.
I'm sending an emergency signal to the Republic. We need a science expert down here. If Tabaro's telling the truth about Isotope 5, we're still stranded, and that Hutt's going to slaughter us all. Hurry to Tarlum and stop his droid.
Galaxy coming to. Hutt's invading, planets cracking in half, and now that, whatever it was. Somebody tell me what that was.
It appeared to be a droid, Mayor.
Here I was, thinking it was a shiny Wookiee on stilts wearing turbo lasers for a hat. A droid indeed. Who the blazes are you?
I'm a Jedi Knight, here to protect you, on behalf of Shayla Mavesta and the Galactic Republic.
Thought as much, what with the lightsaber and all. Good. This mesa's already collapsing. Now, I've got wounded people everywhere, and all the working shuttle pads are outside town.
Shalem can get more shuttles for the evacuation.
What we really need is the one thing those Hutts won't give us. Time.
Mayor, we're getting emergency alerts. The Hutts are landing reinforcements, mercenaries, and more of those droids.
Lovely. I'm the one-legged woman at the droid-kicking contest.
They're holding the shuttle pads. We'll never get off the mesa unless someone drives the enemy off.
It's a big mesa. Surely there's another way off it.
Those droids are fast, and their weapons have enough kick to take us out from a distance. If you can't handle them, we're dead. Just clearing off the pads isn't enough, though. We need to stop the Hutts from landing more reinforcements until we've all evacuated.
We could erect energy shields, Mayor. Cover the pads so they can only be used for flying out.
Solaire, you're actually useful. If we got you some energy shields, could you set them up at each landing pad?
Can't you just run for it once the shuttle pads are clear?
Our wounded move too slowly. You've got to buy us more time. Gather the wounded, prep for evacuation on the double. We are leaving.
Take these energy shields. Activate them at the landing pads. Good luck.
That's far enough, thank you. I doubt even the Force can stop me from pulling this trigger. Best not to try.
Please, the next groundquake could destroy this mesa. Kill us all!
Then let's keep the negotiations brief, hmm? We've done no harm to these people. All we seek is the droid's Isotope 5 power supply.
You're not taking anything. We destroyed that droid. We're keeping whatever's inside.
He's not bluffing. He'll kill me.
No time for debate. Let us have the Isotope 5, or we'll be forced to execute the prisoners. I'm sure no one wants that.
Whatever your mission is, it ended the moment you crossed me. Drop your weapons or die.
We cannot return empty-handed. If we must die, it will be as soldiers. Kill them!
The Imperial warned you this would happen. Why couldn't you just let them go?
I never meant for this to happen. I thought I could stop him before he pulled the trigger.
We'll have to leave the bodies. We barely have enough speeders as it is. I should contact Shalem. Let him know we're bringing wounded.
Thank goodness you're... Wait. Where's Mayor Erkins?
The mayor's dead. This whole mesa has become a combat zone, and it's crumbling to pieces. We need to evacuate the wounded right now.
We've established a medical triage center. I'm sending the coordinates, Allaire. Get your people to it. I've also relocated to a new camp near the Ark construction site. I'm transmitting coordinates. Meet me here to plot our strategy.
You're concentrating all of your forces in one area. Tabara won't resist that temptation for long.
Our proximity to the Ark limits the kinds of attacks we can make. Aerial bombardment is now off the menu. A Republic engineer just arrived. He's analyzing the Ark schematics now. Get here as soon as you can.
Ah, you're here. Good news. Tarlem's refugees evacuated safely, and no fresh reports of Taboro's droids. You bought us time, and we'll need it. This is Gazadar, one of the Republic's top engineers, and a brave man for coming down here.
Couldn't pass up a chance to thank the legendary Jedi who saved Coruscant. I was there when you stopped the planet prison.
Have you verified Taboro's claim that the Ark will only run on Isotope 5?
I analyzed the Ark schematics. Despite them being borderline incomprehensible, I can now say with authority that they reveal Taboro's threat is authentic. The Ark was specifically built to run on Isotope 5. It's the only energy source capable of pushing that massive vessel through Makeb's atmosphere.
I still haven't heard a decent explanation for what that substance is. What makes Isotope 5 so special?
It appears to be a radioactive variant of Illyrium, unique to Makeb's planetary core. From what little I've examined, it's nearly a template element. Isotope 5 can be modified into all manner of useful configurations, including a potent fuel source. But I'm no expert.
Then we need the real brains behind the Hutt cartel's operations here. Dr. Juvard Ilip Ogarab. And we know where he is.
Whoa. The only 5-time winner of the Beodur Science Prize is on Makeb? Are you saying he designed the Ark?
Probably those droids, too. Dr. Ogarab has been holed up at the Sanctuary Research Complex since before his people invaded. If anyone knows about Isotope 5, it's him.
Why would a Hutt scientist help us at all? Isn't he with the cartel?
Dr. Ogarab is well respected across the galaxy. For a Hutt, he's pretty reasonable. The Sanctuary Research Complex is one of the most advanced experimental laboratories in the galaxy. It's on an isolated mesa completely under Hutt control.
There's no telling what sort of defenses a genius like Dr. Ogarab has there. And you'll be going in blind.
There are data access terminals on Sanctuary's testing grounds. Try accessing one. It might let you disable any unwelcome surprises. Otherwise, good luck.
I don't care how well defended Sanctuary is. I'm tougher. I'll have Dr. Ogarab back in time for dinner.
I have no plans to feed him. It would cost a fortune.
And please, for the love of science, don't hurt Dr. Ogarab. I didn't bring a way to preserve his brain.
It's high time you Republic agitators showed up. Taboro and his brutes have this entire facility captive. I was wondering if you'd ever bother liberating it.
We're not getting a stable image on this end. Who are you? And how do you know us?
Please, call me Lippy. After all you've done to the cartel, everyone on Makeb knows you. There are many on this mesa being forced to work as slaves. We would be honored to aid your attack. We possess detailed data on the lethal security grid Taboro installed across the mesa. We'll help you destroy it so you can enter the main complex, and we can escape.
If you know how everything works and you're on the inside, can't you deactivate the grid from there?
Like my peers, I am confined to my laboratory. It required considerable ingenuity just slicing this comm channel. I am transmitting data on several key objectives. Each will provide you ample opportunity to convey your displeasure with Taboro. Stand by. Follow those instructions precisely. You'll not only gain access to the main complex, you'll destroy Taboro's security grid. We'll speak again when you breach the main complex entrance.
Taboro's security grid is down. We're entering the main complex.
Splendiferous! You've eliminated many of that bully's unforgivably barbaric thugs, but more remain inside the complex. Once you've eliminated them and disabled any internal defenses, we will evacuate Sanctuary. Your heroics are most appreciated, and we will return the favor. It is obvious you came for the illustrious Dr. Ogorob. We're transmitting his coordinates so that you may quickly find him. Best of luck. Gava Dumpa Stupa, Maragisa.
Yokanta Patachawa Lermo. Moki Ilema Wata. La Jobanum Botafa, Avatikuna Chi Dunik Nanoria.
Jobe Chupa. Kasoya Rikoi Radre Tapa Chapapa.
The Republic hasn't made friends with the Empire, and the Doctor doesn't work for us. Not yet, anyway.
Agua Oscar Puno. Oscar.
Duti Puna Puna. Manchi Kabuk. Numis Limo.
Uchimo. Uban Chomealipa Isti Patoga.
Churlish nincompoop. You can see why I was forced to lend my brilliance to your assault. I'm glad you're here. My apologies for the earlier subterfuge. A necessary contrivance. Taboro seized control of my defenses and was watching me closely. But I am no one's prisoner.
You helped us defeat your own security grid. I thought your people only spoke in Huttese.
All Huts can speak your language. We simply choose not to. Given the circumstances, I prefer to avoid linguistic misunderstandings. We have complementary goals. You want what Taboro possesses, and I wish very much not to die here. Provide me with transport off this doomed planet. I will aid your efforts to recover the isotope 5 fuel rods that power Taboro's Ark.
You're the only halfway decent Hut we've met in a while. I suppose that should count for something.
How fortunate for me that my brethren have profoundly lowered your expectations. I have a personal shuttle here. It's large enough to accommodate us all. Thanks to you, we can now fly. We should leave before Taboro sends an army to kill us. Take me to your allies, and I will explain what must be done.
Doctor, it's such an honor. I'm so glad we weren't forced to kill you.
We held up our end of the bargain and got you to safety. Tell us about Isotope 5, and how to fuel the Ark.
Isotope 5, Taboro's great discovery at the center of Mekeb. Something truly unique in all the galaxy, and worth destroying this planet to obtain. Imagine a substance as light as shimmer silk, but stronger than Durasteel. It distorts gravity and electromagnetic fields so predictably that it can be refined into fuel. Isotope 5 has limitless potential to remake this galaxy. Those droids you battled were first-generation prototypes. Playthings.
Stop making excuses for your shoddy workmanship. I trashed your playthings, and I'll break anything else Taboro throws at me.
Sadly, I doubt you will encounter my more advanced designs. I crafted a beautiful set of Isotope 5 fuel rods to power Taboro's Ark. Some of my finest work, but you'll never see it. According to my data stream, Taboro has increased mining production to maximum levels. Mekeb's destruction will arrive far ahead of schedule. You have a spacecraft, yes? We should depart immediately.
We won't abandon millions of Mekeb refugees. You said you could help us get the fuel rods back.
That was before I saw the latest updates on Taboro's drilling operations.
The mining platforms are massive lasers drilling directly into the planet. Shutting them down would release core pressure and buy us time.
Attacking the mining platforms would be suicidal. Even worse, it might kill me. Wait, why do I get the feeling you're serious?
What does Taboro have guarding these mining platforms?
With a steady supply of raw Isotope 5, my former employer can power a multitude of devices designed to exterminate all trespassers.
We need to deactivate all of Taboro's mining platforms. That's the only way to slow Mekeb's destruction until we can get the Ark's fuel rods.
I fear it won't be as easy as flipping switches. The platforms and their control rooms will be heavily defended.
When it comes to body count, Mekeb's ground quakes have nothing on me.
I suspect that's not an exaggeration. I'll have a transport to the mining platforms prepped for you immediately. Keep us apprised of your progress.
Thanks for the assist. Private Vandalic, 8th Imperial Infantry. Might keep your distance. Insects leaking out.
You didn't come alone. Where's the rest of your squad?
Scattered around.
Our forces were thorough. Droids especially. Not much time, so listen. Wasn't always Imperial military. Born on Makeb. Caught wind of the Hutt takeover. And volunteered for this. Defend my old home.
Either the Empire's getting sentimental, or it doesn't know your true loyalties.
Good for the mission. Knew the terrain. And the people. Orders were to steal Isotope 5. But I wanted to help your evacuation. Still have friends and family here. Shutting down drills, not enough. Need to open emergency release valves at primary control center. Reduce core pressure.
You're a soldier, not a geologist. How did you figure all this out on your own?
I grew up on these platforms. My father was a foreman. Use slicer spike in control center's mainframe. Override HUD security lockout. Take control. Vent the core. Control center's heavily guarded. Sorry, that part's on you. Please get my people off this rock.
On my honor as a Jedi, your loved ones will be saved.
I believe you. Wish I could stay.
Lemda, Gez, we're at the drilling site's primary control center. An Imperial soldier, an ex-native, told us to open the emergency release valves. He said it was the only way to release planetary core pressure. Do you agree?
Tectonic vibrations are still off the charts. Coranto Mesa just exploded. Good thing we're not there. Those drilling lasers were working overtime. The heat buildup beneath the planet's crust is massive. Venting the core would cool things off.
All that heat has to go someplace. Is there a way we could direct it to take out Taboro's forces?
Nice thought, but no. Normally, venting that much heat would cause an environmental catastrophe. But at this point, who cares? Working. Readings show seismic activity falling quickly. That should buy you enough time to get the Ark's fuel rods.
We're still cutting it awfully close. Can we use this equipment to reverse the core's damage?
If we had months, maybe. But we don't. We've had an interesting development while you were gone. Dr. Ogarab isn't the only Hutt on Makeb who's changing sides. The local Hutt cartel leaders, minus Taboro, want to negotiate with you personally. Hurry back to camp and meet us in the diplomatic tent.
You sold us out to that maniac Taboro. Now that he's turned on you, we're supposed to save your skins? Incredible.
Had we known Taboro was insane, we never would have supported him. He is no longer Hutt Cartel. We formally shun him. However, in breaking ties with Taboro, we find ourselves stranded on Makeb with you. We are prepared to offer generous compensation for seating and cargo space aboard the Ark.
Cargo? Are you delusional? Your bodies take up more room than a dozen good people.
Ah, one of the Republic's greatest heroes. Just the person we could use to bring some wisdom and perspective to the discussion.
Let me see if I understand. Taboro's former friends got on his bad side. Now they need to get off Makeb, so they've come to us?
The major cartel leaders have decided Taboro is bad for business. They want peace.
Most revered Republic champions, my masters apologize for this unfortunate situation. Surely we can reach a state of mutually beneficial recompense and earn passage aboard the Ark?
My people deserve rescue. The Hutt Cartel's leaders can't just beg their way out.
Shalem's right. But these are the most powerful Hutts in the galaxy. We can name our price to save their lives, and think what that means for defeating the Empire.
They'll say anything to get what they want, and the minute we turn our backs, they'll stab us.
They wouldn't dare. You hold all the power here. You can force them to commit their fleet to our side. Taboro has lost his mind, and these cartel leaders know it. They can't go back to him. They need us.
Honored Republic heroes, you are known for mercy and greatness. Can you find it within yourselves to forgive our profound error in judgment?
As a Jedi, the Sith are my greatest enemy. One day there won't be any of them left to fight.
Are there any reasons I shouldn't eradicate the Hutts next?
Honored Republic negotiators, my masters will happily continue debasing themselves, but Mekeb's time grows short. If you provide safe passage for my masters and their cargo, they will fully commit the cartel to an alliance with the Republic. Surely you find this agreeable?
You'll commit a lot more than fully. The cartel cost the Republic time and credits that could have been spent defeating the Empire. We'll need your technology, your mercenaries, your warships, and your money. Keep giving them until we tell you to stop. That's our offer. Take it or leave it. Your masters can enjoy Mekeb's destruction from front row seats for all we care.
My masters wish no further hostilities with you. The offer is accepted without condition.
I think you're the first in galactic history to force the Hutts into a deal they can't afford. Now all we need are those fuel rods. Dr. Ogarab is with Shalem. You should coordinate with them.
The cartel has deserted you, Taboro. You have no allies left. Don't be a fool. Give us the fuel rods.
I think you're overestimating your real estate, Taboro. When this planet goes, you're going with it.
That inbred imbecile has abandoned all sanity. You'll have to take the Ark's fuel rods by force. His palace is a testament to my artistry. I poured my spirit into designing lethal defenses. I also left myself a private entrance inside.
A secret back door? I'm starting to like you, Ogarab.
My charms are legion. Taboro will have far more than my inspired designs guarding him. His most lethal soldiers and Isotope 5 droids patrol every corridor.
We'll hold this position until you get back.
Without those fuel rods, millions will die. If you can't get them, I'm canceling your parade.
Tell your people not to worry. We'll get those fuel rods no matter what.
Be safe.
You now have coordinates and the security code to my secret entrance. Once you're inside, contact me for more information. Don't die.
Your hidden entrance appears to be unguarded, Doctor.
Of course. Taboro doesn't even know it exists. He has no eye for such exquisite detail. He is also despairingly predictable, and almost certainly ranting away in his throne room while clutching the fuel rods to his bosom. I am transmitting procedures to defeat the security protocol separating you from Taboro. Follow them precisely. I'll be unable to reach you via holo after this.
What if we need more information from you?
If you use my instructions, you won't. The palace employs transmission dampers to prevent unauthorized transmissions. You'll be on your own, I'm afraid. A last word of advice. Taboro asked for some rather unorthodox droid designs. It's possible he actually built a few. If so, good luck with them.
Yuna, Liska, Chananga, Wachi, Kospaini, Huntinka. La Joba Numbotafa, Avatikun, Achido, Nignanolia.
This world became part of the Republic the moment we landed here. You're the one wasting time, Taboro. How do you plan to kill me, Taboro? Your awful breath or rolling over?
Ha! Kaya Shrek Kurola Woska Kwa Bobana. Huni Joka Nucha Chikawa Una Chichi Tua.
Oh, no, you don't. Nobody kills you but me. The Ark's fuel rots, as promised. Taboro's gone, along with his entire supply of Isotope 5.
The whole planet felt it. Lemda says the explosion triggered a chain reaction in the planet's core. If you have unfinished business, better make it quick. I'll take the fuel rods and get our people to work installing them. I left a shielded shuttle here at the camp. It's your ticket off Makeb. The rest of us are taking the Ark.
This has been quite a vacation, but I think it's time to go home.
And for us to find a new one. I hope we meet again on Keylander Station.
Hey, look at that. We are alive. Nice work.
Fuel rods are in place. Power levels are at 80%. I hope it's enough.
It'll have to be. Lemda says there's a fissure opening directly beneath us. We're launching before the mesa collapses.
Scouts reported the catastrophe on the surface. We feared the worst.
When have I ever let down the Republic?
There's always a first time. I'm glad it wasn't today. Please meet me in Keylander Station's conference chamber. We have much to discuss.
The Supreme Chancellor requested a meeting.
Welcome back. I was informed that you survived a terrifying ordeal. You have my deepest admiration. Ah, here they are.
Millions of hungry mouths to feed and nothing to show for it. You pledged Makeb to us, Shalem, and you knew it was doomed.
We had no idea the planet was that unstable. Our offer was made in good faith.
My uncle is a businessman, Chancellor. But in this case, he's telling the truth.
You knew the groundquakes were getting worse. You used the Republic, knowing we'd be obligated to help your people even if you had nothing to offer in return.
What's done is done. We have a vessel filled with millions of refugees who need food, water, and medical treatment.
And a home. My people can't live on that Ark forever. They're packed in like cargo.
This is a debacle. We came here seeking resources to defeat the Sith Empire. Instead, we're walking away with debts and obligations.
What about the Hutt leaders? You negotiated a peace agreement with them, didn't you?
Hutt promises aren't worth the time it takes to hear them lie. They're all scum. We can never trust them.
I have no intention of trusting them, but I'll exploit their fear of you for all it's worth. Only the cartel leaders who needed rescuing agree to this alliance. Fortunately, they possess most of the wealth and power. They'll neutralize any holdouts. With our new friends' wealth and warships, we've gained a substantial advantage over the Empire. That doesn't address the problem of Makeb's people, however. I need a solution.
The Republic needs to establish a haven for war victims. I can't think of anyone more deserving than the people of Makeb. The Hutts have plenty of credits to fund the construction of new homes, and we can use their fleet to protect them.
I had to twist your arm to call the Republic. Glad you finally swallowed that spirit of independence?
After everything we've been through, to receive such generosity. Thank you all.
The people of Makeb need someone guiding them to their new home. I think you're the right person for that job, Shalem.
I'm not. But you've shown me what a true leader looks like. I'll follow that example.
I want to speak with my operative in private. Please excuse us. You've made the best of an unfortunate situation. Well done. The Hutts want to be on the winning side of this war, and you've shown them who that is. We have you alone to thank for this alliance.
We still have plenty of fighting to do. The Empire isn't falling anytime soon.
Indeed. Which brings me to my next point. For too long, the Republic has wasted time reacting to the enemy. We must fight this war to win by going on the offensive. Savor this victory. Return to the war's front lines and press our advantage. Together, we will be triumphant.